the time of peasants, kings, and Vikings. I'm on my way to Melo. Welcome to Valtuvegin, or at least I think that's how they say it, a genuine state-of-the-art Viking village. Yes, almost everything in this village is as close to historically accurate as possible. That is, everything except yours truly. I'll shrek in a potato sack here.
So do I look alright? Am I good? Yeah. Pull yourself in a bit, mate, also.
Yes, I do. Well, just in case we get attacked, I thought I'd better have a knife. For 10 years now, people from all over the world have come here to see, live and stay in the village. And as long as they dress and behave themselves and keep their pillaging to a minimum, the king says they can lobby here for free.
They have different types of happy roofs. You can see wooden roofs, you can see the straw roof.
And that is literally just dirt and grass.
Yes, yes.
And it grows and that's the roof.
Yeah.
And depending on how you do the clay,
this the wall there.
No.
You take sand, straw,
yeah,
water,
yeah,
and cow shit.
Cow shit?
Yes.
Cow shit's the thing that's out.
Cow shit.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Mm.
Yeah. No, it's an international language.
Yes, cow shit.
Yes, it's an amazing village, and you know it even has its own currency.
So you're a rich man?
Of course, I'm the richest.
You're the richest?
Yes, yes.
I am what we in Sweden call the law man. I write the law, so mine's very important.
Every now and then I can hear coins being made.
Yes,
your
yes. That's my service, mate.
Yes.
It's your own head.
Yes.
And I wake up in the morning and say, God, what a good day. And then I just go out in the kitchen and say, Olaf, make me 10 new silver coins, and then I become a rich man. You like things, my dear friend. And I have a beautiful little
silver coin. It's a dragon. It's a dragon's head there. You can see that sperm.
Spoon? Are you crazy? What are you using when you are going to the toilet? Cleaning your belly button?
Is that really what they claim for that
song? Of course.
Really?
Yes, it's called an red peanut. It's a stick that you clean your bottom.
Do that is for cleaning your backside.
Yes.
I'm glad you told me that before.
You can't do that. That's a spot.
Oh, no. Thanks for the heads up on that.
Why get it back?
Who's the hell is wiping your bum with a stick? If I was living here, they'd need to give me a boat oar. Now, they're actually in the process of putting together a communal toilet. It's not finished yet, but when it is, I'm told as many as 12 at a time can sit together and play pickup sticks. Good on them. Once the sun goes down, the place really comes to life. I accidentally stumbled across a bit of a neighbourly biffo. I wonder what's Viking for giving me back my lawnmower, you bastard. Oh, hello. That's got to be the man of tonight's grog, isn't it? Welcome to the 21st century. Stumbled in on a midwinter celebration. Yep, they're putting on a big bash for the god of fertility, Freya, celebrating the longest day of the year. If we tried to do this in Australia, pass a bowl of beer around, it would last 2 seconds, it'd go to three people to be gone like a magic show, but gotta get back to the king with a little bit of beer in it. Well, I hope it gets back to the king with beer in it, or I'm gonna be beheaded or befruited or benutted or something. I don't know. Did you know that in England there's a Viking museum that has one authentic artifact that Melmo doesn't have? Yep, a genuine fossilized Viking turd. Lucky bastards. Now, speaking of turds, there's a company that makes and sells them. With over 600 on offer, you can choose from Floater, King Kong, Scarface, Full of Shit, Shit Set the Fan, Shit the Ripper, Dumb Shit, Lazy Shit, Cow Crapula, Holy Shit, Shout Man, and of course, Hannibal Lecter.
And so you like giving a lot of shit to your clients?
Yeah, and they take it.
Business,
they pay money for it.
There you go.
Yeah.